Hello, ladies and gentlemen. It's Charlie Fibrosis, and I hope you all are doing well. It's time to race Darlington. I am not looking forward to Darlington, and we are low on money. So we are in poverty class here, ladies and gentlemen. We are getting poverty team. We are hitting the low numbers, and we also tore up our Daytona car. Our Daytona car is no more. So we have got to build a car for Talladega and hope that it works well, because that's just what we're going to have to do. Let's see here real quick. So we do have an engine that is still being built. We got six races. What does that put us at? I think that does put us at Talladega. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It's going to be cutting it really, really close. Alright, so here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go ahead and get our car built for Talladega and hope that we will have it still alive for Daytona next year and go from there. Can't do any R&D, so... Alright. Here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna run Razor for Darlington. And I think I'm gonna sell one of my most beat up engines available. We still have Junker sitting around. We need some money, is the thing. We'll put Thunder's chassis in Razor. Alright, well, we got a little bit of money and we lost a little bit of money, so let's just see what we can do. Alright, here we go, qualifying time. Great. We got the pole. We got the pole. We got the pole at Darlington. What the heck? Oh my God. Okay.
MRN Radio is here at the Great Southern Tradition, the annual Mountain Dew Southern 500, here at Darlington Raceway in Darlington, South Carolina. Barney, drivers love coming to Darlington because of its history, but they often leave wishing they hadn't shown up. Why's that?
Well, this is an egg-shaped track with different lengths and different bankings in the east and west turns. That makes it very tough for the drivers. But the question is, why is it egg-shaped? Well, when it was built, the landowner decided he didn't want his minnow farm disturbed, so they simply pinched in the corners of what is now turns 3 and 4 to give it the distinctive egg shape that it's now famous for.
The Grainger car has not had much of a year so far on these speedway tracks.
And a good finish would go a long way in boosting that team's morale. I guarantee it would make a whole lot easier to come to these racetracks.
Sterling Marlin picked up Rookie of the Year honors in 1983, but it took him over 10 years to find his way to victory lane.
But he made it there in impressive fashion. If you have to wait that long to pick up a win, you might as well make it a big one. And Sterling did with a win in the 1994 Daytona 500.
Kurt Busch started on the...
We beat the Rocket Man for the pole.
In the front row are the Grainger car and the...
Ooh, we blew the doors off Newman. Okay. Well, let's see what the 60 car can do. By the way, congratulations, RFK Racing, Roush Fenway Keselowski Racing, managed to get their second win of the season, and back-to-back wins with their current driver, Chris Buescher. I didn't even touch Newman, and he just took Rudd to the cleaners.
Keep running that line. That lap was bad. Number 9, that's gonna run on you. Number 12, contact with the 12 rope. Here's the point. Off there, buddy.
I'm surprised the car is actually still running pretty damn good right now. Just does not like the middle of 3 and 4. Don't kill me. They killed me. They killed me pretty damn bad. Well, that's gonna cause some complexities. I did not need to bring out that yellow, and I wasn't even trying to. Coming out of this race alive, though, is probably the most important thing. The thing is, there's not an ally rivalry system in this game.
Clear all around.
Someone blew up. You know what the problem is? I know in my heart that I can catch the two, and I can probably get these three, four positions. I just do not have the car anymore to confidently do it. I'm having to play so much hard defense against the guys behind me. They are going to the outside and inside trying to get around me, all the while I'm trying to save my tires, but I know that I have enough throttle to be able to make it work where I can catch Rusty Wallace and a host of these other drivers. My car just does not have the same grip like it did earlier. And I'm happier walking away with a 10th place finish in the process, even though that it sucks, because I know I can do better. Twitches, the car is getting, that's where I know that we're not doing right. Where it's a straightaway or biting right into the corner, we're good. I'm happy. Yep, I'm gonna just surrender 9th, 8th, and 7th and just focus on holding on to a car that can get a top 10. That's what we can walk away with.
The 17 car, hello.
12th place. Alright, I can work with that. 12th. I wanted a top 10. We got 12. I will take that. Oh, Christ. What a horrible race car. Right there at the end, just limps it to 12. Oh, man. Oh, God, that was stressful. And Dale, Jarrett, and Ricky Rudd are going to finish 1-2. DJ in the 88 is going to walk away with the victory.
There weren't very many lead changes.
Yeah, I guarantee you there's at least 35 or 40 other drivers who wish they had seen the lead.
The Grainger car didn't finish where he had hoped, due in part to the damage on his car, I'm sure.
You know, some of these teams have multiple cars, and a race like this won't set them back too far. It's the guys who have only one or two cars that suffer the most. But hey, it'll make you learn to take care of your car in a hurry.
We're out of time here at MRN. We hope you enjoyed today's race, and we'll see you next time.
That's a lot of good money right there. I will take that. I will take that to the bank and we can work on stuff. Alright, let's see what we got. Wow, that was good money. $1.79 million right there in the bank. I think we will use... We will save Junker and we will save Razor. I was wanting to use Flash for Daytona, but you know what? I'm going to be completely honest. I think Flash, we're going to use this for Richmond and we are going to walk away with a win. I think that's what we're going to do. We're going to use Flash for Richmond and we are walking away with a victory. Let's look at team management real quick. We'll build Rumble later on. Rumble is going to be a speedy car. Alright. Let's look at something else real quick. Jeez, oh beez. This is thus far been a good season. 14 poles. We've had a solid average start. We've just had a poor average finish. We've led the most laps on the season. That's badass. That's so cool. Alright. Let's do this for Richmond. Set up in. Alright, let's get another pole. Let's get one at Richmond.
Let's make it
go, boys. Another pole. Another pole.
MRN comes to Richmond, Virginia for tonight's race, the Chevy Monte Carlo 400. Richmond offers a little something for everyone, doesn't it, Barney?
This is a fast track, even though it's less than a mile. Richmond's smooth surface gives the drivers plenty of room to maneuver and make clean passes, but you'll still see a fair share of bumping going on out there.
The Grainger car, one of the crowd favorites of these short tracks, had another impressive qualifying run.
Man, is it paying off for those guys. Seems like each and every week that car is starting in the top 10.
Steve Park has had some tough breaks during his still young Winston Cup career. He missed a bunch of races in both 98 and 2001 due to injury.
Yes, and unfortunately those injuries cost him a shot at Rookie of the Year and his first top 10 points finish. But he's back now and as good as ever.
Jeff Green joined Richard Childress Racing in 2001. It was the first year RCR had run three cars at one time in Winston Cup.
And being a part of a very successful multi-car operation is important to Jeff. His first foray into Winston Cup was a little rough, but with Childress, he's got a good chance to run well week in and week out.
Here we go. See if we can finally win at this track.
Help me.
Jeff Gordon with another blown engine. Well, that's kind of good and bad. Good in that I'll be able to pit, but bad in that I really wanted to get some distance over second and third. Jeez, peas, what a massive wreck. So the 26 just spins up 20 and the 26 gets killed. I don't know how many cars are involved, like four? Go. Oh my God, Rusty. What the shit, Rusty Wallace? Took me out. Like a goddamn bitch.
Thank you.
all the grip that I needed is now gone. All because Rusty Wallace decided to be a shithead. It's over. I cannot get the same grip, and I cannot get the speed off the corners like I want, like I need. And I can't run the line that I was running so well earlier in this race. Gain distance and get time. So alright, we're just gonna have to settle for second, and just next season we'll attack Richmond and hopefully get a win finally. I'm less mad over the fact of finishing second, and just more mad that A, that did not bring out a yellow, and B, that it happened in the second half of the race, right when, you know, things were really clicking off in the first segment. So last thing I want to do is spin this car out, so. Yeah, tires are gone. Hey, Rusty Wallace, go eat a pack of shit. What a crock of shit.
We usually have more cautions than that, don't we?
Well, that was good news to the guys who ran out front. More cautions would just have meant more restarts, which is more chances for you to lose positions.
The Grainger car suffered some damage in this one and ultimately paid the price for it.
Well, Joe, they're bound to have bad days in this NASCAR Winston Cup Series. The key is having a team that can put everything back together and continue forward at the same time. These guys will be fine.
This has been NASCAR Winston Cup Racing, brought to you by EA Sports and MRN. Next up is New Hampshire.
Alright, well, there's that. Damn, we didn't even get 18th, we got 20th. What the hell, man? Alright, well, that's gonna wrap it up for this episode, guys. Thank you all for watching. I'll see you again next time.